to the Knitting Place podcast. This is podcast number 61. I'm Dinah. You can find me at the Knitting Place on Instagram, Ravelry, and Facebook.
I am Pam Sapp. You can find me as Pam Sapp on Ravelry and Instagram, and Pam Sapienza on Facebook.
Welcome, everybody. If you have never joined us before, this is a knitting podcast where we sometimes cover crochet.
Sometimes we talk about knitting.
We cover our WIPs, RFOs, new products, and today we're not wearing anything. Well, we're wearing something, but we're not wearing any knits.
Kind of out of a little bit of knitwear weather, right? A little warm.
Happy summer solstice.
Oh, that's right. It is summer solstice.
It's my Zachy's birthday. So wishing him a happy birthday. He's in Greece right now.
God bless him.
He just got to the island. Was it Ilo that he said?
I didn't hear it.
Yeah.
I never heard of that anyway, even if it
was. I'm not sure. But he's exploring and having a wonderful time.
You need to come closer to me, Dan. You're hanging off a little bit. There you go.
Okay, I'm covering the FO, though.
Well, we can always move them.
We could just go right into it.
That's right.
I have an FO.
Diana has an FO.
I have my Marseille.
She's happy to have that FO.
I'm happy that it's done. This is the Marseille. It's designed by Petite Knit. It's knit in Sanis garn. You've seen it for several weeks.
Several weeks, right?
Over a month. I don't even know when we started it, but it's done. And it's not completely done. I have lots of ends to weave in.
Will those ends ever get woven in?
They will. They definitely will. The neck knit up beautifully. I did a modification. I did not do the turning hem round.
Oh, you didn't do the turning hem round.
I just went completely straight. I wanted it to match the tubular bind off. So I figured.
Oh, that's why you didn't do it.
I didn't do it. So mm-hmm. The tubular bind off looks like it's an infinite roll of knitting, and I wanted the neckband to have the same. So what I did is I just knit the 20, I think it, from my size, it was 26 rounds, and then I did the bind off.
Ugh, you're going to have 26 rounds of ribbing to do on that?
Yes.
I've got 30 rounds of ribbing to do on my cuff.
I think I did more than that, actually.
On the cuff?
Yeah.
What? How many rounds? 26 did you set on that thing?
Well, it was 13, a turning round, and 12.
And 12.
So 26. I used, in case you missed it, I used Andrea Mowry's technique for the jogless join on the sleeves. I love the way it worked out.
We were admiring how her stripes on her sleeve match her body stripes, right?
Yeah, I'm quite impressed with the instructions here. When I have this on, it definitely lines up beautifully.
It's nice.
So I'm super excited about that. What else can I share?
We use
the Celine LaRue provisional cast-on technique. That she has a YouTube video, as well as Andrea Mowry. They both have YouTube videos on the different techniques that were used for the Marseille. And it was a pleasurable knit.
It really was. When you stop, that's a lot of knitting. We began that, I think, in early May.
Was it early May?
Yeah, because I was hoping to be done by early June.
It took 2 months.
It's taking me as long to knit the sleeves as it took me to knit that whole body. And that's sad.
We go through like ebbs and flows. You know what it is? It's like you hit a span where you're just like, you get a lot of knitting done. Yeah. And then I just tend to lose steam on something. Yeah. And then it goes
back burner. Weekends for me are usually good times to get some knitting done. The past 2 weekends, I really have not gotten much done at all.
Father's Day, you were very
busy. Well, that's a little of this, a little of that. But, you know, I'll show you where I am on mine. I mean, I have gotten farther than I was last week. I know I told you last week it would be done this week.
So I set my little goals. I don't know if you saw my story. No. So my husband was away, so I had a little more time to knit,
which
is probably why I actually finished it. But I said that each day I would knit the band plus the stripe on my sleeve.
I paced myself
like that was my mini goal. Don't forget, I also had my test knit out.
Right.
So I wasn't taking up time with that. So I was able to focus on this a little bit more.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I think I was looking. This is where I've gotten this much
you
of
were
the
only,
sleeve
I think
done.
It, you only had the first stripe done.
I was on the first, yeah.
Yeah, so you got a lot done.
Well, that's not for the whole week. Well, I mean, I'm also knitting the Willa. I did not even pick up the Willa. I knit not. Well, I did. I knitted during the Zoom. last week, and I was knitting away. I must have done, I don't know how many rounds I did, a bunch of rounds on the yoke, which is a lot of stitches. And I said to Dinah after the Zoom, I said, I have to take it all out. It just was uneven. I didn't like the way it looked.
It was looser.
So that night I went home.
And you undid what you did.
It took me, I can't tell you how long it took me to undo those rows. It was just, I must have spent, I probably spent over 2 hours knitting and I got nowhere.
Did you find it difficult to rip out the helical?
It was a little more difficult. I had to, untwist it. And it wasn't hard. It was just time consuming. And don't forget, I was doing it at the end of the day. If I'd been doing it maybe in the morning, I would have been a little fresher. Maybe it would have gone a little more quickly. But I was determined to get that out that night. I wasn't going to leave it. If I left it, then, get it.
I learned my lesson. I think I had done... I saw you guys on Saturday night.
Yeah.
Right? I finished the cuff, and I knew, don't do the tubular bind-off. Only fresh in the morning. Exactly.
That happened Learned to me my the lesson. Previous week. I was ready for it to do it Saturday night, and I said, I'm not doing
not
it.
Not doing it.
Do it the next day, because you'll go through. Because on that one, what
so
I did was...
fast when you're fresh and sharp.
That is true. However, I zipped through that sleeve tubular bind-off only to look down and see...
You were off.
That there were 6 stitches out of rib pattern on the sleeve. So I had it. You know how long it took me to take out the tubular bind off?
Oh my goodness.
That is not gracious. Fun. Twice as long as it took me to do the tubular bind off.
I keep thinking about.
And I had no mohair in there. You were thinking of Grace, right?
Yes, Grace.
God, I was thinking of the same.
How many times did she take it out?
Well, she had mohair in it. And we finally said, you know what? We're going to do it without the mohair. No one's going to know if you have mohair in your tubular bind-off. But anyway, so that's my history with sleeves. I always have issues with sleeves. Not that the knitting is hard, but I do these stupid things. What are you going to do? It's life, right? It's part of knitting. Anyway, so this is my progress on that.
I did make a promise to myself, speaking of sleeves.
What's that?
I'm going to jump onto my sleeves on the cuffle.
Good, good, good.
And then I still have to do the other one.
Which one?
The Felix.
Oh, I finished the Felix.
I know.
So we're about the same. I'm not done with my body and my cuffle, but my Felix is done.
Right. You're probably.
But I have not kissed on Winter's Beach. You've kissed that on.
Yeah, so I just wanted to finish the rest so I could show
I have done nothing. I tell you, like I said, I haven't had a very
productive
week.
It's the end of the year. You're busy. You have a lot going on.
Yeah. That's true. But now.
No more Mondays left.
Exactly. I was telling Dinah that we were saying in school, someone I work with was saying, okay, the way you have to look at it is you have 4 Mondays left, 4 Tuesdays left, and then you can say, oh, there's only 3 Mondays. I said to her today, we have 0 Mondays left today. We're almost done. But I was going to say something about my knitting.
Whatever. Did you want to share your Willa?
I mean, I can. I haven't done anything on it, but
well, maybe if we have
you'll see what I ripped. Maybe I don't even know what condition I've left this in from last week, but it should be fine because, as I said,
I love the speckles in that.
Yeah, and again, the helical knitting is lovely on this.
So we had a few requests asking us to explain what is helical knitting and why it is used.
Here you go. Isn't that lovely? I have a beautiful black dress to wear into this, Dinah, a summer shift. The colors aren't coming up as nice, as vibrant as the speckles.
They actually are, right.
You think they are?
No, I think it's prettier. I hate to say it in person.
It's prettier on that side.
It's prettier in person.
It's a great quick knit.
Very pretty.
You could even make this out of a fingering linen. How pretty would that be for the summer?
It would be stunning.
Like
the new
from Shibui or something like that.
Absolutely. Or the new Tin Lena.
Tin Lena. Mm-hmm. Too many yarns
Very
to
pretty.
Choose from right there. Anyway, so that's that.
So helical knitting is a technique that's used. Sue, for one, this is for you. it is used when you have hand-dyed yarn or yarn that might be different colors or different shades, different dye lots, and you want to alternate.
Blend it in.
Helical knitting is used when you alternate one round at a time. It's in the round. And it's used to offset the color change. And it is done so without actually leaving a mark or a jog when you're changing your yarn.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what helical knitting is. And that is the reason why it is used. And then another person had asked if I could explain how I'm using it in my project. So I don't know that I'll be able to share it because it would be a lot for me to go over. I just lost a marker.
You sound like a couple of them.
I think you're right.
Oh, dang.
That's okay.
You know where they go, right?
I do. I'll have to pick them up after. So let me find out where my yarn is, and then I will see if I can explain it. So this is where my yarn is attached.
It's blowing out. Yeah, that's better. Yeah.
So my yarn is attached to this stitch right here, which is a purl stitch. So when I go to do my helical knitting, you're supposed to stop about two or three stitches before this yarn. So I would stop about here, and somebody had asked, how do you keep that in pattern? I'm not sure if you can see it, but every helical round, I have two purl stitches in a row, whereas the pattern has one round of a relief of knit. I'm probably getting too technical.
You are getting technical.
But I will show you. It's very hard to see, and that's the point.
So what Diane is saying on that knit round, you are doing that stitch as a purl. Is that what you're saying?
No.
See, I don't even understand what she's saying. What are you doing? What do you do in the relief row?
So it's a two round pattern.
Right.
One round is knit, mm-hmm. and one round is knit two, purl one.
Okay.
I am staying in pattern, mm-hmm. but when you do the helical knitting, there's a grouping when you're doing this technique that those stitches are not worked.
Correct.
They're not knit.
Correct.
So if I'm on a knit round, there is no knit round on top of the purl. Therefore, I need when I'm on my next round of knit two, purl one, it's stacked. Purl on top of purl. Does that make sense?
I have to see it in my hands, for me personally.
Okay.
Because I'm not, you know.
So the problem is there's a gap where the stitches aren't worked in helical knitting.
Correct.
And it's not a problem when you're in the round, and it's not a problem when you're in a pattern stitch. You just have to make sure that you stay in pattern, regardless of the missing stitches. Because in the end, the floating stitches that you don't see, it's not visible.
Correct.
I mean, it's just not visible. This is the section that has...
Is that whole sweater in that stitch pattern?
Yes.
The whole sweater is?
Yes. Hmm. So basically, this is the section that I did the helical knitting, and it still looks like it's in rib, and you can't tell that it is jogged.
Right.
That's basically the point.
There you go.
I'm sorry if I didn't explain it well. Pam is clearly frustrated that she doesn't understand, so you guys
must be not. No. That's just me. I have to have something in my hands, you know, for me.
Yeah.
To see it.
Well, it's important to know. I mean,
you can't do that if you're not. Clearly, you have to stay in pattern, whatever you're doing. So, you know, you can't just do it if it's not going to keep you in pattern. You have to do something.
Correct.
And that's what you're doing. You're making an adjustment so that you can keep that in pattern and do the helical knitting.
I'm not necessarily adjusting, because if I was adjusting, mm-hmm. I would fake the pattern.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm actually staying in my two round pattern regardless of what I've skipped. That's really the essence of what I'm trying to say.
So in other words, when you're coming, this is the stitch, you have to stop three stitches before it.
Right.
So you
technically
stop the three stitches
those before. Knit two, purl one, I didn't do.
Right. Right.
Right?
Right.
So when I come around again and I'm on a knit round, I'm going to knit. But if I'm coming around again and I'm up to knit two, purl one, if I didn't do the knit there because I, you know, that was the round that I jumped,
mm-hmm.
my purl is going to be stacked on top of purl without the...
But you're not doing anything.
No.
You're just doing the same thing.
Exactly.
So you're not doing anything different.
No. But I'm not doing anything different, but it aesthetically, if you really, with a, you know, a magnifier,
you say it's not, technically it's not right, but you're not doing anything.
Correct.
Well, I thought you were doing something.
No. No. So that is
That's
key.
Much easier
yes,
now.
Yes, exactly. That's key. And in right. any, I mean, in.
So you're saying that that you're doing
a void.
It, but there's it's not like stitch for stitch, so to speak, not stitch for stitch. pattern stitch for stitch.
Correct.
But even though it's not, you don't see it.
Correct. Exactly.
There you go. Oh, now I understand.
She got it.
Only took three tries.
She got it.
Oh, I'm sorry, guys. That's I'm shaking okay. the table. I apologize.
So now that I pulled that out, I should really tell you what it is.
This what are you
is
my, knitting, Diana?
This is my Flora sweater. I didn't get
another one. Markers? Another one.
How is that even possible?
Oh, my goodness. Over here. Somewhere over here.
Oh. Okay.
There you go. That's what your Monday night
this is my Flora sweater. It's a design by Ari Shimizu. It's a beautiful top. I noticed that one of the gals that I went out with this week, she's knitting it and she's already up to the rib. It looked pretty cropped. I think I'm going to have to add length to mine.
What do you mean? The rib on the bottom?
She was up to the bottom already. Yeah, right. Nikki.
Well, that's a harder, and that's a hard, it's not hard, but it's knit 2 for $1.
Yes. And I am sweater. Going to do like a generous steam to open it up just to see how much I'm actually going to add, because I know that it will open up in a wet block.
That, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So I will open it up and I'm very happy with it. It's very light. It's very subtle. I'm using Suburban
Stitcher.
Well,
that is a nice thing with the fingering yarns. They really are lovely.
Yep. I'm using Suburban Stitcher sock. Mm-hmm. This is the colorway Sugar.
Nice.
And I'm hoping to spend a little more time on it.
Mm-hmm.
So that's exciting. I can't believe I lost more markers.
We'll have to search the floor.
Okay.
What's next?
So my next whip, do you have any other whips?
No.
So we have begun our Winter's Beach cardigan knit along.
Oh, so you got a lot. You've been now. She hasn't got a lot of knitting done. Come on.
But
you got done. You did that. You finished that. You're working on
I didn't really work on the florist. I tried to get a little bit done on here. I don't even think I have an inch done. But that's okay. We're going slow.
What is it? Knit 2 for $1? Knit
1 for $1? No.
Oh,
so
if
this
you're
is,
setting it up
right,
for the cables. Okay.
Right. So this is important. On this, Winter's Beach Cardi, we have a Zoom and we're talking
about. Do you have
your markers in? My markers are in place.
Your markers match your speckles.
And we were talking about how markers are your friends. And in this particular case, they're marked off for different types of rib sections. So that's important. And they will move later on. And that's it. This is my progress. Not very far, but we're taking this one slow.
Well, you're not wearing it now anyway,
no.
Right?
No. Hope to have it ready in the fall.
There you go.
And that's about it for my whips.
But what are you doing, Diana, today?
I'm casting on a new sweater. I'm going to celebrate the
Never
summer
enough solstice. Cast-ons, right? Never enough.
I don't know which one I'm going to cast on.
Oh, you haven't decided?
No.
What's it between?
I'm thinking it's between a few, unfortunately. It's between Dingley Dell.
Dingley, I knew you were going to say that.
Because I've never knit that.
Mm.
I do, however, have my eye on a second Rocket Tee.
Oh, don't do it.
Don't do it?
I mean, if I were choosing between like a Dingley Dell and re-knitting something I've knit, I would do the Dingley Dell.
I love the way my Rocket Tee fits me.
Yeah, I know you do. You do.
It's very, I mean, the Dingley Dell has a very similar style if you're not familiar with it.
You have a picture of it?
It has the V-neck.
I like the Dingley Dell. I wanted to do the Dingley Dell.
Where is the Dingley Dell? I may have to pull it up
how
on my
How dare I cast on something when I can't keep up with what I have?
And how do you think the bold stripes would look? Flattering or unflattering?
They're thick stripes. They're wide stripes,
they're
though.
Wider they're bands.
Not, if they were narrow, I would say, but they're wide stripes.
Okay. Then there's also the Laya. I mean, this is gorgeous. This is
like
Isabel's
that.
Kramer. Isabel
would, it's different. It's different. Don't
Maybe
you
I should do that.
I mean, I know you like the Rocket Tee. It's a
I
great
do.
Fit. What
I
were
do.
You going to do the Rocket Tee in?
I have my eye on Chicory and Steampunk by Suburban Stitcher.
Oh, that's lovely, too.
Can
what would
do
you do
that, with
that
this?
In? Wait. You're talking about that now?
For, no, the, for this, I might do something different.
Oh, I
these
thought
are
you were talking
bolder.
About... Right.
I might do 2 solids here.
I would do 2 solids.
Yeah.
That's what I would do. Decisions. Honestly, Dinah,
yes,
you knit that Rocket Tee so quickly last year that you could knit another one real fast. Would you do it with a, excuse me, mohair or 2 sock yarns?
2 sock yarns.
Would you do the eyelets on the raglan?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We'll see. We'll stay tuned to see what Dinah casts.
I don't know
on.
What it's going to be.
You never know. There might even be something else that comes up.
Yeah, there are other things. Because I do. Here, hold on a second. I have them in my notes. So, do you want to pull out your phone?
What do you want to show them?
The other ones were the tulip. I could do the tulip Guernsey.
Oh, that's pretty too, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I had that on my list. Mm-hmm. I have Lithium by Astrid Mueller.
That's the other one.
Now, that one has like a little, it's like a cap sleeve with the detail, and then the rest is plain. There's Cloudlessly by Isabel Kramer.
Yeah, I've seen that one. Mm-hmm.
And Laya by Isabel Kramer.
Yeah, the Laya we've promoted.
Right.
We've promoted
that. So they're all very pretty.
Yeah.
Which one are you looking up?
I'm looking up the,
let me see if I get
you some. What's the first one you said?
Lithium?
No, that's not the one I'm looking at. The tulip Guernsey.
Oh, right.
Here it is. Sweater. I'll show this to them. This is a tulip Guernsey. Look at that. The short sleeve version, I'm assuming you're talking about.
Yes.
That version.
Love that. Isn't now, that'll pretty? Go fast.
Yeah, that's very pretty. And she uses, if I can come back to the pattern. She uses
a worsted weight, if I'm
well,
not mistaken.
Well, she's saying lace and sport equals worsted, so her gauge is 16 stitches in stockinette after a wet blocking.
Easy
so
breezy.
We were talking about Lena, right? Is that what we were talking
yes,
about?
Yes, Lena.
From Saniscarn.
Doubling it.
The cotton linen acrylic blend. No. Oh, you were going to double that, or were you going to use the Lena?
I think I might use the single.
Really?
I don't know. You're mm-hmm. thinking I should double the Lena?
No, I would do it singled.
Right.
I would do it singled. Correct. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. I'm
that's
gonna
a
find...
lovely knit. That's it's done on a looser gauge, so that would be interesting to see. What's that one?
This is Lithium. So it's got the detail going down the side, as does
oh,
the Rocketee.
Too.
And this is like
now you
a little.
See, I would do that before I would do Rocketee.
A honeycomb stitch on the cap sleeves. So that's also cute.
Yeah.
That's called Lithium. By Astrid Mueller. Then there's Cloudlessly, because that one we haven't really mentioned, so I would like to show that
one
too.
Cloudlessly is not new, is it?
No, these are not new designs. Mm-hmm. We just haven't really
right. I think I have Cloudlessly in my favorites.
Why isn't it coming up?
Cloudlessly? Let's see. Patterns. Let's see. Is that the right name?
Yeah, let's look up.
Oh, Elizabeth. Of course it did. It did an autocorrect.
Hold on. This is terrible. I'm sorry, guys, but it's a cute top.
Yeah, here it is. I did it so that it can't change it. Here it is. Oh, not Cloudless.
No, let me find Isabel Kramer because I
it's
didn't find it either.
Up. Maybe we're saying the wrong. Maybe it's not Cloudlessly. Maybe look up Isabel Kramer. That's the thing to do. Yeah.
Sorry, guys.
But anyway, so there are so many summer
she
tops
also has
this
the
year.
Laya.
The Laya is lovely too. I know how to spell.
You want to show them the Laya in the meantime while I look for this? Laya. So terrible.
This is the Laya. The Laya is a quick.
Oh, it's one S. Of course, it's one S. Here it is.
Oh, that's why we couldn't find it. Come on. I keep changing it.
This is Cloudlessly, spelled with one S in case you're looking for it. So that's another pretty one. It's got the pattern going up the back.
Oh, that's nice, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it's plain in the front.
I
and
like
it's got
the
a
Laya.
Little deep
the Laya is
detail.
Lovely.
At the bottom.
This is the Laya.
And there's the Laya.
It's pretty too. Let me get it's a hard decision.
I know, it's hard.
Well, in my opinion.
I need another, I'm excited because that's
one,
a summer tee.
Or the, even the first one you showed, the, what was it called?
Dingley Doll?
No, the was it?
Lithium with
lithium?
The
yeah.
Caps.
They're
leaves.
More similar. I mean, the Dingley Doll is a different look because of the stripes.
Right. I mean, the Laya reminds me of Ranunculus and Love Note.
Right.
It has that same kind of feel. Hopefully I'll be able to get at least two done.
Not before next week.
I'm just casting
on. I thought you were saying at first I'll get too
tired. I want to cast something new on today. I'm so excited.
You should. You should. Something fun. Get it done.
And then I was also thinking summer sorrel. We have those beautiful kits.
The summer sorrel is lovely too.
That's different. Maybe I'll just do that because that has that fabulous.
Yeah, I told you should do something different. There she goes. Was that me?
So anyway, stay tuned. I'll have something on my needles hopefully by next week. So should we share what we have?
Yes, we should. What do we have?
A new design by Tammy Gore. It's called Shades of Peony. It's a beautiful shawl.
Do you have the paper?
Yes, we do. We will share that with you. I think this pattern dropped.
When? I saw it today. I don't know.
It might be today. I'm not sure. But the discount is only, or it could have been over the weekend. The discount is until tonight?
No, the 30th.
Oh, so you guys jump on.
20% off until June 30th.
Yes, Tammy Gore.
This is it. It's called, what's it called?
Shades of Peony.
Thank you.
It uses 3 shades of fingering weight yarn.
Right.
Lovely way to stash.
And the nice thing about it, too, if you have stashes at home, you might have a partial skein. It uses 3 colors, 325 yards, 335 yards, and 255 yards. So you don't have to have, you could have gone into a.
You could have gone into like a bigger skein and maybe just used a partial. This is a great way to maybe use one of those colors in the shawl. She's using 3 colors. It looks like she's used a gradient in the sense that it's a light speckled, a medium, and maybe a darker speckled.
Right. But it doesn't make a difference.
Of course, it doesn't make a difference. We have some exciting news. We're also going to raffle off.
They could make that with it too.
One kit at the end. Stay tuned, but Pam reached 1,000 followers. Thank you so much for subscribing. This
Thank
color
you.
Is getting blown out, but this is a beautiful
so
kit that we're going to be giving away.
And she says it's a mix of garter, eyelet stripes, and a short row border. It's meant to be a relatively laid back knit and something you can reach for on a movie night or telephone calls that were only supposed to be a few minutes but somehow turned into a minute. I can
Somehow
relate.
Zooms tend to be that way.
Oh, anyway, she has some great patterns, Tammy Gore. So
yes, I had done that one test knit. The
right. Who doesn't need a
color craze
a summer? Right, and it's I think it's done on a 5 needle. So.
What's the wingspan? Because that's like a pretty
okay,
one
sure
too.
I will tell you in just a second.
Wrap around. Nice! It's 116 inches wingspan, and then
47.
Yep, very nice. Well, that's the width along the border.
She
so that would
say.
Be the width of the bottom of the triangle.
And this is the, I
She's
know
sharing
it's
the depth.
She, hold on. She has, I thought I saw a schematic. I guess I didn't. I thought there was, no, she doesn't have the depth. She has the wingspan along the top edge and the width. What does that mean, the width along the border?
I'll tell you. So basically, the wingspan is the top of the edge of the shawl. That's right. 116 inches. It's an asymmetrical, and this is your wide border. It's this length that's 47 inches, this part. Very pretty.
Anyway.
So we have assembled some kits for you.
Absolutely.
We're excited to share.
I'll stick this under here. And we'll show you some of the kits that we've assembled. Let's start with this one. Pretty, right, Diane?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe that way.
I think this got messed up.
No? Mm-hmm. Well, then let's start with this one, and we'll make our way.
I don't know. Is that it? This is with the blue.
This one goes
yes.
with this.
No, this goes with this, and
that
this goes
with.
No, that goes with that.
Yep, that's right.
That this
is correct.
Okay, sorry guys. Okay, this is the kit. This is very pretty. So we kind of did a gradient.
Yep.
And this one is gauche. Cold shoulder and amethyst.
And this one is, let's put it this way, Picante. Do you know what they are doing?
Picante, Maori silk, and I think this one is Jiggly.
Jiggly.
Giggly.
I've never read that
Giggly.
Name. Giggly. Giggly, GG, I'm not sure what it is. And this looks like a flower to me.
This looks like Lily, is that
correct.
The Lily?
A Lily Pulitzer.
Pulitzer,
yep.
Right.
It's ELO. With sprinkled raspberry ice cream in the center and celebration on the end.
I like that.
How pretty is that?
Mm-hmm. Very pretty.
I'm going to hand you this one, Dinah.
This is Across the Universe, Cosmic Silver, and this one here is called Io. I kind of like that one. Very cute. This is a little more turquoisey blue. There it is. Oh, love that combo.
And
sorry for reaching.
That's okay. This one here, this one on this end is turmeric, Sirocco, and Gold on Mad.
Beautiful. Pretty, huh?
And here, I'll hand you this one.
Love this one.
I know, that's a fun one.
This one is red, blood orange, and love.
That almost looks resembles her original one. A little bit.
I love this kit. Sorry.
That's okay. And this one is pretty.
That's a great one, too.
This is Pearl Harbor, Flatware, and Monkey Business. How cute are they?
Now, all of these kits are different. Like, we brought in all of... So, we're trying to show you that you can do it with any fingering weight yarn.
Correct. Absolutely.
We're using Clarendrad. We're using Madeline Tosh. We're using Moondrake. We're using...
Bell.
Artfill Bell. We're using Murky Depths. Neptune Singles, Asylum Fibers. This is a sweet one. This kind of reminds me of the Casa Pinka vibe. This one is called Cherry Baby, Platinum, and Transorbitable. These are all by Asylum Fibers, as you can see.
Yep.
A house fave.
This is a pretty one. This is Teal Cake Salad, Wool. Cake Wool, Emperor Honeydew, and Love Sponge.
Beautiful
How
trio.
How pretty is that one?
That's a great trio,
That's
too.
A nice one.
Beautiful.
And this is a pretty too. This is using Moondrake yarn. It's called
Stunning.
Golden with Sunset in Taiwan and Amethyst. How pretty is that?
Beautiful.
That's a nice set too.
Oh, you know what? That's the Amethyst. I think I messed up. This one, that first one that I showed you, I apologize, is called Deep Violet.
Oh, that one, yeah.
This one.
Yep.
Sorry, I goofed.
There you go. And this one, this is a fun one. This is like shades of pink. And isn't this a
gorgeous?
This one is simply called, the first color is called red. Second, can you hold this for me, Diamond?
Barbara deserves better.
Thank you. And this one is bloom or bust.
Stunning.
How pretty is that?
Stunning.
Right?
Yeah, that's a beauty.
One. There's one more that's in the blue-gray family.
Is the Artful Bell.
And this is Denim. This
Stardust.
Is Stardust. And this is Claire de Lune. How
beautiful.
Pretty is that?
Very nice.
So all nice kits.
Yes.
Again, you can build your own. You may have some at home. You know, that skein or two of
anything
fingering that,
coordinates,
that we always
yeah.
pick up, right?
Absolutely.
Anyway.
I think they just need to have a little contrast.
Right.
I think you saw in the picture one of them is just a little bit lighter than the rest.
Right.
You want them to blend, or you could just have three bold, bright
do
colors.
Do whatever you want.
Exactly.
That's the fun part of it. Yeah.
Make it happy. Make it your make it your own.
Yeah.
So thank you, Tammy, for another beautiful pattern.
So what Dinah was telling you about the giveaway later, you can easily do that with it if you wanted to, right?
Or you could pick something else.
Exactly.
But that's our inspiration for you today.
You could do an unwind.
It's going to be your job.
To do what?
To ask them a question.
Thank you.
So you better think about it.
I don't know.
Yeah, sure.
I don't know. You may have to help me with that. Anyway, and that's that. Right?
Yes.
What else?
What else should we talk about? Let's talk about another kit.
Okay.
Actually, do you want to talk about the new colors that just came in?
Oh, yes. We just got a shipment today of Spin Cycle.
Yes.
Yay.
You're hearing about it first, but they might see it on Instagram Live.
Correct. Right. And we got in, I think, two new shades in Dyed in the Wool. And did we get two new shades in
Dream State? I believe we did. So with that, we decided to, we got a beautiful restock in a lot of colors, as well as some, Versus, which we were able to create some new cinnabar shawl kits. So we certainly updated that, and this is the cinnabar shawl. It's designed by Andrea Mallory, and these sold out quickly when we had them, so we figured we replenish them while we have it back in stock. And it's just some inspiration. So stay tuned. We'll show you some kits. Should I start in the meantime,
Pam? Yeah, go right ahead. I'll be right there.
Okay. So this is a color that we first had in Dream State. It's Wololo, and now we have it in Dyed in the Wool. It's a beautiful self-striping yarn. As you can see, there's variation, and that's the beautiful thing about Spin Cycle. No two skeins are alike. They spin and hand dye the yarn, and each one is different and unique. So for this cinnabar shawl, we paired it with Wilder in the light gray, and we thought it would stripe up and do a beautiful, it's a brioche pattern, by the way. It's half garter and half brioche. So we thought this would be a dynamite combination, brand new color. So it would be a beautiful kit.
It's nice.
Yeah, it's a really nice kit. Should I continue? Or
yeah, show the kits.
Okay. This is the original kit. So this is Devilish Grin, the original colorway that she used, and she paired that with Slow and Steady in Verses. Now, the difference between Verses and Wilder, the Verses is two-tone, and Wilder seems to be just one, the pearl gray. So this is the original kit, lovely for those of you who've been waiting for it. It's finally back in stock.
Yeah.
This next kit is another classic look. This is Shades of Earth, and we paired that with the Wilder in the light gray, which is also very pretty.
Mm-hmm.
And we kind of went with self-striping yarn, not self-striping. We went with colorways that are a little more stripey as to see the
So you get a nice
variation in the shawl. If you look here in her original shawl, do you see the, I mean, this was one colorway, but you see the variation of color
change
going throughout.
Color, right.
So it adds another layer of interest as opposed to just a two-tone.
And there's a nice, we also tried to do a nice contrast.
High contrast, colors, exactly.
So you'd really see it.
Now this kit is dynamite.
Oh, I love this kit.
Can we make only one of these? This is going to sell.
I don't know if we have more of the. We have more of this color, but I don't know about that.
This is.
I don't think you can do more.
This is called Close Call, which is another new colorway in Dyed in the Wool. Thank you, Pam. And this color here is Time and Tide. Absolutely stunning.
Beautiful.
So this is like, how would you describe this? This is a green and gray marl.
It's almost like a seafoam.
Stunning.
Or a, with gray twist
just
together.
Stunning.
And this time, this is this Close Call?
Yeah.
This, it has usually, the last time it had gray in it, but the gray this time seems to be more of a green.
Greenish
or,
gray. Mm-hmm.
Or like seafoam. I can't even explain it, but it's
stunning.
Beautiful.
It's beautiful.
Beautiful.
Mm-hmm. And that like amber color. But
yeah.
It's gorgeous.
There are two kits that I personally like.
Then there's this one.
Telltale Heart.
Which is like a yellowy green.
Yep.
Very pretty. And then this one is Suit and Tie.
So nice contrast.
Very nice contrast.
Oops.
So this is beautiful. Now this one, the background is a little deeper.
Mm-hmm.
So your brioche will pop forward.
Right. More.
Very nice. And last but not least, another winner. I mean, the kits are different. You might have seen like more neutral ones. But these happen to be beautiful.
I love this one.
This one is gorgeous.
This is one of my favorites. Again, you're not. It's hard to see in the on the screen, but this color is Labradorite, which is has browns and dark blues. Correct?
Yes. I'm going to see if I could just bring it a little. There
That's
it is.
Better. Yeah.
Absolutely gorgeous.
But show them what you're putting. Put the one you're putting
it
with
gorgeous.
Up close.
Oh my goodness!
How pretty is that?
Coming up.
And again, there are really good pictures. If you go to the website, they're really
amazing.
Pretty
this
pictures
is such a
that
great,
you can see
yeah,
what it looks like. This
is
one
a great
is
kit.
Gorgeous.
Okay, so we showed you the two new colorways that are available in Dyed in the Wool. And you don't have to buy them in the kit. They're available online, sold separately. And then we also are restocked in Wallflower. It's a color we haven't had in a while.
And Overshadow.
This one here is Wallflower. Very pretty pink purple combo. And this one is a new colorway, right?
Yes, it is.
This
yep.
one is called Overshadow. And this goes in the blue purple colorway.
And then we have, I didn't mean to do that. I think this is a color. I don't know if we've had this in Dream State before, Overpasses.
No.
So this is new for us in Dream State.
Very pretty.
And I know we haven't had Good Omen in Dream State.
No, we got that last time only in Dyed in the Wool.
Dyed in the Wool. And this one kind of is like denim-y blues with like some pink and
very pretty
burgundy. So that's another pretty color in Dream State.
Thank you, Pam.
You're very welcome.
Okay, what else should we talk about?
You should talk about this. And we could talk about the, you know, since we're talking about this, we can talk about that. Right?
Okay.
Behind us.
So you want to, let's talk about our new sample that's here in the shop. This is the Lace Top by Sanis Garn. For those of you who don't follow us on Instagram, this top came in with the delivery with the Sanis Garn Tin Lena. Did we talk about the Tin Lena last time?
Yes, we did. It just come in.
It had just come in. So we got new colors as well as this top. And the book sold out. This was the cover of book 1908, and we are going to be getting some more in.
It's called, and I believe the name is just called Lace Top.
Yes.
T-O-P-P, though.
Right. I think it's one word.
Right.
And you can find it on Ravelry, but you can't purchase it. You would need to purchase the booklet. Right. And we were informed that we're not allowed to sell the booklet without the yarn. So if you are interested in any of the booklets from Sanis Garn, the 2104, the 1908, please call us and we can arrange for a color or a video FaceTime. We could show you the patterns in the book, the different images.
Can they Google the pattern, like just to see what it looks like or see what the images for book 2104 might be?
I think if you go to Sanis Garn, right, which is the name of the company.
You can see what's in the book.
Yes,
and then you can
do
the
lookbook. And they might cover the span of what you'd need for the actual pattern.
Right.
That's a very good idea.
Right. And I was going to say something. I forgot. Whatever. The books were very popular. The books, that's what I was going to say. The books will be in about 2 weeks.
Yes. Yeah, so we have a round. Right. We're getting a delivery this week.
Oh, we are.
Yes, right. A generous delivery. But we have a huge amount, a huge number of requests. And I think we're oversold. So we are getting another batch in... We're hoping in 2 weeks. It may not be that quick. Of late, we know, through our Marseille redelivery and the redelivery of Double Sunday, it took a little bit longer than expected. We are not expecting this to come in by boat, so hopefully the air delivery will be a little bit faster.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But we're doing our best, and I know that I can get them in, so we are taking pre-orders. So if you are interested, please call the shop. Be prepared to give your credit card to reserve the book as well as the yarn. So do your homework.
Exactly. And the Tin
it's
Lena.
It's really lovely. It's
the Tin
a lovely
Lena
yarn.
It's soft. It's lightweight. It's a cotton. Now, it's a cotton linen acrylic blend. But, I mean, I think if you... It doesn't feel like cotton.
No, it feels like a cotton linen. It feels more linen than cotton.
Right.
It has a nice hand to it.
I agree with that.
And it's a lovely alternative to fingering weight yarn that patterns call for fingering weight yarn and wool. And we know that we have a lot of clients that have are in warmer climate, our Floridians, West Coast customers, our Southerners. This is lovely. So
but even shawls, the Morgana shawl. Dinah did the Morgana shawl out of alpaca silk. You could easily do it out of this.
Right.
Or any
you
of the shawls. You could use it for this.
Right. You could pick up 3 shades.
That's the lovely thing with
you'd actually, I think in this particular yarn, you'd need 2 per skein, but they're not
expensive.
Right,
you would need 2 per color, right? And it's very reasonably priced.
This is actually the put up.
Yeah. Speaking of shawls.
Yes. So there's a new shawl. It's called Ice Cream Social. We do have...
we had the white ones, but we're sold out of the white.
Yes, so but we're going to be restocked. So by the time this comes up, you may view this before it's available on...
But it will be available later
by
this
the
week,
end of the
so
week.
It's not a long wait.
And if it's something that you're interested, you can always email us. So we
or
did.
Or they could build their own.
You can certainly build your own. We'd be happy to help you. And I also have hand-dyed yarn coming in, especially for this kit. So
fabulous,
stay tuned.
Fabulous, fabulous.
Yes. You guys want to see a sneak peek?
Yeah, sure.
Share?
Why not? Why not?
And
the nice thing about this shawl, the Ice Cream Social, I'm going to show you this close-up.
These are hand-dyed finger and weight minis.
Perfect.
That are going to be available. So if you're not down.
No, those are wool.
These are wool.
Right.
Actually, it's a wool blend.
Oh, it is a wool blend.
Okay. Beautiful.
Now this is the shawl. A closer look at it. And you can see how on one side, this side, the lace is white. And the stripes, that I don't know if it's garter stitch, I'm assuming it is in the various colors.
Right. And on this end, I think where you start, you're doing the lace pattern in the color, and it's interrupted with white or the alternative color.
I just think that's lovely.
It's fun.
Right. And of course, they're showing it now with a white, with the all the different colors, but you could easily, you could
We had kits with gray as the background, black as the background, white as the background. We have a light beige here. We're going to show you this one just to give you a sample of what we had pulled together. Can you help me out?
Yeah, sure.
This here is the main color.
This is the main color. This is the color 2331. Again,
it's a light beige.
It's a light beige. That would be a nice main color. Well, of course, and that's why we picked it.
Right. I have to say, I think I like this. I mean, we love our kits.
I don't have to hold all of these, but you know, this is going to be the color that will run throughout as the
and
main.
And this,
Dinah's showing you, can you get
is
it?
Our alternative rainbow.
Got it here. This is going to run throughout, and those are the other colors. It starts with a deep, like a slate, and different shades of yellow. Yellow, green.
So this beige would interrupt every single color.
Correct.
This happens to be a very pretty neutral kit.
Very pretty.
Yeah.
But as I said, again, if you want to build your own, you just need 4 skeins of the main.
And tin lina.
And tin lina. And you need 1 skein each of 6 different colors.
Correct.
So it's really not bad. It's, what, 10 skeins, right?
Yeah.
Beautiful.
No.
So the...
And do you want to share the different techniques used?
Okay, sure.
I think there was a center double decrease, just for those of you. If I'm not mistaken, is this actually charted and written?
Yes, it's
this
charted
pattern
and
is,
written.
Yes, which is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Some
it
people.
Uses, go ahead, I'm sorry.
No, I was going to say some people are intimidating by reading a lace chart.
Well, you have all the words here.
Right. So in this particular case, this pattern, by the way, is designed by Lisa K. Ross,
I believe.
Lisa K. Ross. Yeah. When you have a pattern that's written and charted, if you have never followed a chart, it's nice to have the written version so that you can try to follow along both. And
it's also a good way, if you're not comfortable with the chart,
yes,
you can have the words, but if you look at the chart as you're doing it, I bet
like you're gonna
find that it's easier for you to follow the chart.
Absolutely.
Because they have the symbols in here are yarn over, knit 2 together, SSK,
right?
Central double decrease, and that's it.
And it's, I don't know, I find reading a chart to be a lot easier.
It's a lot easier. I don't want to hold up the chart to show you, but she has them on here, and it's quite large. It's larger than you would normally find a chart.
And it's a 6-stitch repeat, and when they have a chart, it's usually, you're going to want to print your pattern in color. And what happens is there's a repeat, and the repeat is highlighted by a box in a different color. And I often recommend, I think you do as well, when you see that repeat, that highlighted box, that's where you might want to place markers. And you always want to make sure that the stitch count remains the same between your markers. In this particular case, it's 6 stitches, and it's a very easy way to check yourself to make sure
that you're on target.
That you're on target.
Very easy to forget a yarn over.
It's such a great tip.
Yeah, because it becomes mindless after a while. But she really, this is very well written, looking at this.
Yeah.
It's very, but again.
And I think it's going to be a fun knit. We sold out of our kits. I think we had one left.
Yeah.
So we're looking forward to restocking. And yeah, that's about it.
Okay.
That's it for kits, right?
Yes, that's it for kits.
Okay.
I don't know of any other ones.
Okay. So always check the website. We put up a lot of kits during the week. We have a lot of fun. We don't want to bore you with all of them on our podcast because we're always showing the projects that we're working on and trying to inspire you with new ones. But you should really check out the website if you want to see what else we have available.
And Diane is now going to show you a new product that we just received in shop.
Yes.
And it is, what would you call it?
It's called Modular Modular. It's a little pouch, and within the pouch, you have a lot of little goodies.
You can make it a keychain.
A zipper pull for your project bag. And let me tell you,
that's a great idea.
It has the most useful utensils in here. You're going to be so super excited. Yeah. So let me just show you.
Oh, wow, that's neat.
This is the pouch, which has a zipper pull, which you can certainly attach to any project bag or keychain. Within this little pouch, you have a hexagon knit gauge, a needle gauge, excuse me. It goes from size 0 to
15. And it also has a 1-inch
gauge check.
Gauge over here.
So,
which is good because you could use it for a gauge.
For gauge.
Mm-hmm.
You also have a darning needle with a large eye. You also have folding scissors, which are really nice. Look at how beautiful these scissors are.
Good at opening these things.
Look at these scissors. Yeah. Great for travel. Great for travel.
They look sharp, too.
They're nice.
Now,
super
here's where
nice.
I cut myself. Closing
Be careful.
Them. I'm not even going to try that
No,
right
pinch
now.
The... Here.
Pinch what?
When you want to close these, pinch the shears, fold one leg
Oh, yeah, that's
up,
the way to do it, yeah.
And then fold the second leg.
There you go.
And last but not least, a little safety pin with rainbow stitch markers, or stitch markers, I should say, because each one has a different set.
So could
the
use
stitch
this
markers,
as a,
needle
use
gauge,
this as a stitch holder too.
1-inch gauge check, darning needle, folding
and
scissors,
case.
And this amazing little kit. So this is the modular kit, and it comes in various prints. It
colors.
Comes in various colors, and we're just going to quickly show you what we have. They're available on the website. We are planning on going live with them. It took a while to get these. We're super excited, and hopefully, if you like one, you'll snag it, because it's one of those things that's nice to keep in your project bag.
Yep.
Or when you travel. So this here is called Mermaid Teal.
And maybe, you have the Mermaid Teal.
Right, so maybe what we'll do is just show all the mermaid colors. This is Mermaid Teal, Mermaid Rose. Look at how they shimmer, they're iridescent. This is Mermaid Fuchsia.
This is the same as, is this the same?
No, that's Mermaid Green.
That really looks like a mermaid, doesn't it?
Isn't that lovely?
Look at that. It's got like a green-blue shimmer to it. Look at that.
Very
That's
pretty.
That's lovely.
So this is the mermaid collection.
Mm-hmm.
This one here is called Holographic Hexagon. So this is like an iridescent, and instead of scales, it's got a hexagon shape.
And this one is called Sparkle Vinyl Onyx. It's got a black pouch. Look at the sparkle on it.
So pretty.
And it's got, what I love about it, look down here, it's got a gold tassel.
So
Very
I wanted
fitting.
To just, can you open that one up? Because
sure.
I want to show them how they're all different. So in this iridescent one, the gauge check, like the darning needle is actually silver.
Right.
You have an iridescent.
Oh, look at this one.
Exactly. That has
it's
the hexagon.
Got a, it's got a black safety pin with silver
markers.
Hexagon markers. And it has a gold darning needle.
So this also has the silver hexagon markers.
And it has the gauge check.
This one here is iridescent to match the hexagon patch.
Right. And so this one is gold.
Yeah,
it matches
the
gold
sparkle.
With the gold. And that's a nice needle. It's a bent tip needle.
Great.
I like the bent tip needles.
So they're super cute.
Yep.
So it's, you know, we love our gadgets.
People come up with these ideas.
Listen,
really.
I mean, I love it. So this is fun. I'm sure if we open up, let's say, the pink, you're probably going to see some pink in there. Lots
What's
of
this
fun.
One called? Yeah, this is green, turquoise.
So this is now the holographic collection.
Yes.
This is holographic fuchsia.
Teal blue.
Holographic rose.
Oh, you have the rose. This one's rose, too.
That's rose gold, I think.
Oh, rose gold. Oh,
yeah, but that's
that.
Not the holographic. What's that one called?
Holographic.
Oh, it is. Interesting. Yeah. Okay, this is holographic purple, which I didn't write on it.
And this is holographic green. Look at that.
Super pretty.
Mm-hmm.
And last but not least, This is the Mirror Vinyl Collection.
Is that, which color is that?
This one is copper.
This one is champagne.
And this one is silver.
How pretty is that? I wonder what the inside of these look like. I'm curious. Oh, it's got a gold inside. Look at that. Very nice.
They're super cute. So hopefully you like our new little gadgets. They're lots of fun.
We like them.
You can find them on the website. They're under Modular Modular, which is the name of the company that makes them.
Yep.
And what else do we have to share? I don't think we have anything else to share. No more FOs, no more whips.
Nope.
So, have you come up with a question?
No, I have not come up with a question.
Come on, Pammy. You can come up with something.
What am I going to come up with?
So you need to say something. Leave a comment. So the idea is we're having a giveaway. We're going to ask you a question, and please leave a comment.
What's your favorite shawl pattern?
Okay.
I mean, is that boring? No. That is boring. It is boring.
That's the question you want to ask. It's not boring.
Well, because it's 3 skeins of fingering weight. So, I mean, you could say they're probably going to use it for a shawl. What else could I ask?
I mean, technically, they can
send that Instagram.
Can they do a V-back tee with it? Is there enough yardage? Maybe not. No.
Probably not. There might be.
Well, you do have to follow us on Instagram.
There might be enough. If it's 420 yards times 3 is 1260. They probably could.
Okay. So the 3 people you have to follow. Pam Sapp
on Instagram.
On Instagram. The Knitting Place on Instagram. And you have to subscribe to The Knitting Place on YouTube.
What is a question, Dinah? That's a dull question. I know it is. But just thinking, is there anything else we could ask? What could we ask? Can you think of anything?
No, I left it up to you.
Thank you, Dinah.
It's your giveaway.
I was trying to think, is there anything in relation to me that they could ask, but I can't think of anything. Just do a shawl.
Okay. So, what is your favorite shawl pattern? Or if you received this gift, would you knit the shades of peony? Or do you think you would?
They could do the unwind shawl.
Oh, there are lots of things. How about if you won this shawl, what would you knit with it?
There you go.
Okay. Let us know what you will knit.
3 skeins of fingering weight yarn.
Yes. Now, just remember, the kits here have different yardages. We actually pulled from lots of different indie dyers. We did give you enough yardage to knit the shades of peony shawl.
Right.
So some three skein shawl patterns definitely go for more yardage, less yardage. The kit that we comprised of has 2 skeins of Madeline Tosh,
which is 420, I believe.
Which has 420 yards. And then we also paired it with one Malabrigo.
Which has, that has more too.
It is has, it 460?
It has, hold on. 420.
Oh, also 420, so the same.
420, 420, 420.
So what would you knit with this shawl kit if you were to win it? And that's about it.
Sounds good.
All right, that's a wrap. Thank you so much for joining us. Please don't forget to subscribe. Hit the bell so you get notifications when we release our new podcast. And we hope to see you next week.
Happy knitting.
Bye.